Good morning, professors. I'm Maurya Pratik and we are here to discuss about the project for TIC. The first question arises, what is this project TIC? TIC is an intelligent time tagging application. And secondly, why to use this application? Suppose that a giant tech giant company or computer manufacturing company wanted to track the field engineers at the various locations, so they can use these applications. So secondly, the third, how can we track the field engineers? We are using a geolocations to track the location of the our field engineer, and secondly, we are storing the records of the field engineers. How much time he has taken to at that particular speed? Our objective was to obtain the one of the application which can track the field engineers. It not only just track the field engineer, it also records the field engineers data also. So that we can the benefit of this application would be that we can find the field engineers as per the customer locations. And the second is they cannot lie to the companies about their works and the expected outcome.
Field engineer should log in into the application where we'll go to field. A computer manufacturer can track the employees from user can log in one time and in which period user can log in application. At that time we show which time how much time user log in application. It will show current location. Field engineer is fetch will help to GPS and also application store in location in database. Current location field engineer means engineer at current location engineer login in application. This location will show in application.
So the tools and technologies and methodologies.
This is the modules we have implemented in our mobile application. So firstly,
the previous slide, like so you use Android Studio, MySQL and
so this is the modules in which this is the modules where we have used in our application. Firstly, there is an intro slider which is introduced to the application, familiarized with the application that this is the application flow. And secondly, there is a sign up login, basically registration module. Geolocation, with the geolocation we get the current location of the user. There is an admin module where company manager can list the employees that how many employees are there in the application, and the timesheet. Whenever user login into the system, means employee login into the system, he can view on his login activities, like which location he has spent how much time. So next.
So is there two logins? Is there
one sign up and two logins? One is for employee and other is for manager, means company's manager.
Basically, sir, this is primary application is for the field engineer. Field engineers can provide the location and it will be stored in the timesheet. But if the manager wants to track, it's the admin side. Manager can track with the unique ID we have provided.
So this is the diagram. Firstly, user will sign up. After sign up, he will log into the system. After login, the check-in and check-out detail will be provided to the user that this location he has to check in, and the stopwatch will start at that location. From that check-in and check-out activity, user will get the timesheet of his own activities. So and customer location.
Where is this data stored? Timesheet, right?
In the database. So there is a separate table for the location, time, and work. What work he has done there. So,
location is being stored or probably you retrieve at runtime using the GPS?
Firstly, I get the location. Mm-hmm. After I get that location, I will store it to the database.
Okay, I will show you the application. Fields that are going to store for location.
I will show you the application, then you will get the idea. So this is the intro slider, which is only one time show to the user that this is the introduction to the application. So now I will show you the application.
You can start.
Sorry?
This is the application.
This is the first main activity. On sign up, user will have to give the some information: first name, last name, email, and password.
So for the UI, what is that you use? Like, it's a native or
It's a material IO. So this is where validation is also provided to the user that you have to put this, you have to give the information to this field. After sign up, user has to log in, means user can log into the system where this is the sign in screen and this is the sign up screen.
Okay, who is going to sign up?
Field engineer.
Just one time. You have what the feature of chain password and forgot password?
These modules will be implemented in future.
So common things that are being sub part of the when you just take the registration module, you have to provide chain password, you have to provide forgot password once the user forgets, and till how much time it takes by default login. Means for how many days it remains for logging. Let's say once I logged in, and I don't do log out.
Yeah.
Next time I just click on the app.
Yeah.
Will I be logged in or log out? And I have to do login once more.
Right now there is a I haven't put the system, but like session. Right now every time I have to log into the system, but
if I don't log out, then also still I will.
The question that he's asking is like, is there a session timer?
Sessions have been handled or not?
No, I haven't handled, but I can. So basically, the time management was not there. So.
Okay, so you are just doing that whatever field person are going to visit some place, they will.
Check in. They will get the current location button.
So when they are sending the current location, what things are going to fetch from there? Means latitude, longitude.
After that latitude, longitude, I will get the idea that this is the this location. So I with the help of geolocation, I find out the which area was there. So I have given the area name. From that latitude and longitude, I get the area location.
Okay, so in database, you have mapped that thing, that if the range is between this and this.
No.
Then how will come to know that particular area is this?
In the Android application itself. Uh-huh. So firstly, I get the latitude and longitude. Uh-huh. From that latitude and longitude, I get the, with the help of geolocation, I get the location name like this. Or Sola or whatever it is.
So that is an inbuilt feature?
Geolocation has that feature.
So you use that intent?
So firstly, I will sign into the system with the help of the email and the password. It shows the progress bar. After I click it on the current location, it will right now it will show you Sola. This is the area. This is the area named Sola. What work you are going to do there? So let's say demo. So I get the current location. I get the what work he is going to do there. And if I click on the check-in, it starts this stopwatch like this. And it will count the time, that how much time he is on the field, like field engineer on the field. So it will count the stopwatch. When I check out, it will show you the intent that data was successfully sent to the database. And after I view, after I click on the view, I get that right now I click on the Sola demo and 13 seconds. I checked in, my checked in time was 13 seconds, and after 13 seconds I checked out. So,
and assuming like when you checked in and your ticker is running, so if there are some other calls or the application is still running?
Yes, this timer will still running.
It will be still running?
Yeah, it's still running.
Background will chalu rahega, right?
Yeah.
Can we check it?
Yes.
Show to sir.
No, that's okay.
So this is the view functionality. Sign out. It will sign out to the system. And this is the admin module. Admin module has not signed up. This functionality we will add in future future implementation. So admin. After login, it will show you the how many employees are there in the system. Right now, sometimes before I put the my email address, and this is the first one I put it, and these all are the employees in the system that these employees are signed up till now.
And when you click on the employee, it will print out the details.
No, right now it is not, but in future we will.
So right now what you're doing is only listing who are the employees.
Yeah,
who are there.
Yeah.
And you're not doing any work allocation.
Yeah. Right now it is a simple version of the application.
Okay. So and where do you have the database running, your MySQL database?
In this
It's on the one of the machines over here, or your MySQL?
Can you show them MySQL database?
Yeah, sure.
Oh, it's running on your
machine,
your laptop, is it?
Yeah.
Sure, sure. So. Sign, karwai. Just provide the hall tickets of each of us.
Sir, usme sirf industry ka hi hai. IBM.
Aaj par dekhna. Main ab dekhne ke baad hi send karta hoon.
Okay.
Jab nahi hai hall ticket, no sign.
Exams.
Hall ticket chahiye.
You want to cover this? So maybe I'll come back.
No.
I only want to see whatever recorded that you just inserted, I'm saying 13 seconds. Can you show me that record?
Yeah, sure. I can.
Say for example your database is not reachable because of some network issue.
Yeah, so I have put in the progress bar in that. So if the database is not reachable, then the progress bar will continue till now. That if database is not responding to the system, then the progress bar will be. Yeah. So user cannot do anything in the application.
Probably maybe still planning to extend this application. So there is a concept, in a way you're not using workline. So there's a, you should try to store it offline on the local cache.
Yeah,
and then whenever there should be, there's an Android APIs are there where we can monitor the network availability. So then whenever it is available, then you can.
Yeah, in the future implementation, I have decided that I put the admin login, all admin sign up also, that all the company can use the application.
Yeah.
So if one admin, there is only one admin, there is no use of the application. So if there is many admins, means all the companies are using the application, that is the benefit to all the application, all the companies.
Thank you.